Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. So, like she said, let me start with telling you about my writing journey. Now, whoever knows me well enough knows that I'm a travel addict. Every time I came back from my trips, I would keep talking about my experiences, the people I met, the food I ate. You know, the stories would just go on and on and on. And one day, a friend of mine told me, "You talk so much. So why don't you pen your thoughts down?" So that's when I started my blog and I started writing travel articles. So as luck would have it, my very first travel article was published by a luxury magazine. And that's when and how my writing career started. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as some of you would know, you know that space above the clouds, in the sky where the planes fly, that is pure magic. You never know whom you're going to meet next. So on one such flight, where I was operating as a cabin crew member, I met a really interesting passenger. That time I didn't know who he was and what he would mean to me. I treated him like any other business class passenger. I gave him fantastic service. I hope he thinks so. I indulged in some conversation with him, just very generally talking about things, and I revealed to him that I've started writing. I've had a breakthrough, I've got lucky, and my article got published. Then you know what he revealed to me? He said, "I'm a publisher, and I'm looking for someone to write me a book on cabin crew members and their lives and things associated with it." I said, "Oh, you know," very innocently. I said, "Oh, okay, very nice to hear that." And then we had some innocent conversation, at least that's what I like to call it. He asked me about my parents, my interests. He asked me how many years I'd flown. At that time when I said 19 years, he looked also impressed. Now in retrospect, I realized that was a mini interview that was being conducted where he was trying to get to know me better. And very short after that, very simply he said, "Would you like to be the person to write that book for me on cabin crew?" You see my eyes wide open now? Yeah? Exactly like that is how I felt that time. I was dumbstruck. I really had no words to say, and I tried very hard to not show it in terms of facial expressions. A few thoughts ran through my mind. I said, writing travel articles is one thing, but a whole book? How would I do that? There was an erratic roster to consider. Trainings, refreshers. I was in one city one day, another country another day. I also used to head flights and would have to write these detailed flight reports. So I said, where am I going to get time to write a book? But then suddenly I thought of something that Richard Branson once said. Sir Richard Branson, owner, founder of Virgin Atlantic Airlines, you know, he said, if anyone offers you an amazing opportunity and you don't know what to do about it, he said, say yes to the opportunity and then decide later how you're going to pull it off. So with that thought in mind, I faked complete confidence and I said, my pleasure, I would love to write for you. So that's when it all began. We exchanged contact details. He asked me to write a few chapters for him, you know, just on a trial basis. And he passed it on to his editor. I think they liked it. And that's why I'm standing here sharing my success story with you about my book, Nothing But the Plain Truth. And I realize now that there will be a day when I will be gone from this world, but my book will remain. So Nothing But the Plain Truth is the journey of a flight attendant called Pari Abraham. As a flight attendant, Pari Abraham embarks on this path that is quirky, that is sassy. It's full of adventures, a lot of times misadventures. She meets all these interesting characters, you know, in form of her prankster colleagues, celebrities at times. When she does her layovers, when she goes on trips, she meets a lot of interesting characters and they somehow shape her personality. So in the book, she starts off as this very timid, naive character who transforms into this lady who is, you know, the kind to take on the world. So you see that journey, and like I said, it is her story. It's a very, very light read. It will make you laugh, it will make you cry. At times it will make you feel for the characters and, you know, at times it will shock you also. So, rest assured, what I feel is it will definitely entertain you. also, you know, when I was writing this book and then I eventually looked at the chapters, I realized that the book has these tiny messages that you might find interesting to decipher as you're reading. So without it essentially being any form of a message book, there are some very sweet messages that you might like. So do read my book. And if you like it, please do go on to Amazon, Flipkart, Goodreads, and do post a review. It will be very helpful to a new author like me. And for today, there are quite a few copies right here in case you're interested. Thank you.